பல்லாவரம் ஃபோகஸ் மென்ஸ்வர் இப்போது மேடவாக்கத்திலும் ஓபனிங் ஆஃபர் டி ஷர்ட் வெறும் 19 ஷர்ட்ஸ் 79 மற்றும் அனைத்து ஆடைகளும் 799 கிடைக்கும்.
ஹலோ அண்ட் வெல்கம் டு கலாட்டா பிளஸ். இன் திஸ் வீடியோ ரிவ்யூ எபிசோட் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு பீ டாக்கிங் அபௌட் பியூஷ் குப்தா தர்லா விச் ஸ்டார்ஸ் Huma Qureshi as Tarla Dalal, the famous cook and chef. The film is on Z5 and it is a film of modest pleasures. It is cleanly made and it offers an interesting look at a place and time. That's a shorter review. For the longer review that follows, there may be spoilers, so do watch at your own discretion. Now, Huma Qureshi plays Tarla Dalal, and I'm going to begin with a scene from the movie. Now, after she discovers that she's become very successful, she discovers that the success has come at a cost. She is not able to care for a family the way she was used to, the way she has been doing. So what her mother does is give her a big guilt complex, you know, because Tarla is actually going to start a TV show and her mother is taking care of Tarla's husband and Tarla's three children at home. And when Tarla comes back home, the mother tells her, "You can be a heroine outside the home, but inside the home, you are a wife, you are a mother, and that is the priority that you should have." Now, of course, all this guilt bears down on Tarla and she decides to quit the show, and she tells her producer that, "I'm only doing what any woman would do." The producer tells her, "No, you are doing what no man would do." The point is made within a conversation with minimal fuss, and that is how the rest of the movie operates, with minimal fuss. Piyush Gupta's Tarla is the story of a woman who wants to make something of her life. Life mein kuch karna hai, she says. And her mother says, "First get married, then do whatever you want to do." And so she gets married to this man called Nalin, played by Sharib Hashmi. Now, Nalin tells her that he will be behind her in whatever she wants to do. So yes, the husband is giving her support, but what is it that she wants to do? What is it that will make her feel that she has made something out of her life? Given the times of Tarla Dalal's life, that is, her first cookbook came out in 1974, the answer is painfully touching, because cooking is considered such a day-to-day thing, such a regular thing, that nobody considers this as a talent, as a skill. Nobody thinks that it is something as big as something that, say, a Shakuntala Devi has. Tarla herself wonders, "Yes, I can understand tuition for maths, I can understand tuition for physics and science, but tuition for cooking?" And yet, that is how she becomes famous. She coaches young women about to enter the marriage market about how to make round rotis, because that is apparently everything. You know, the way to a man's heart being through his stomach and so on and so forth. The better a woman is at cooking, the better her chances in the marriage market. And if she cooks really well, she may even be given a chance to do whatever she wants after marriage, in case she wants to work or something like that, because at the end of the day, she is a good cook. And thus, a girl who is the daughter of one of Tarla Dalal's neighbors, she becomes a journalist because she gets married, she makes great food, which she has learned how to make from Tarla Dalal. And therefore, she's able to convince her mother-in-law that, "Look, I'm able to make all this great food, now let me be a journalist." So one part of me was very happy that sneakily she had become what she wanted to be. But another part of me felt sad that this is how she could actually get to be what she wanted to be, this girl who wanted to be a journalist. In fact, even the reason Tarla takes up cooking to the next level is because of Nalin, her husband. Now, Tarla cannot stand non-vegetarian food. She is at a restaurant and she sees a man eating chicken. She sees the man biting into chicken and she cannot stand it. So she even persuades Nalin to move to another table. But when she finds out that Nalin is a hardcore non-vegetarian, she decides something has to be done. She doesn't confront him. She doesn't weep. She doesn't sulk. She doesn't fight with him. Instead, what she does is do what she does best. She says, "I will find vegetarian options for all the things that you like as non-vegetarian. So if you like murg masalam, I will make you something called batata masalam and satisfy your taste buds." And so through her own special skills, she gets her way. There's a nice touch in having Tarla Dalal's neighbor, played by Bharti Achrekar, an actor who was known for her work in TV serials in the 1980s, because that's round about the time this film was also set in. So the very presence of this actor kind of gives a very nice flavor. It evokes the era. And this lady, this character, gives a very nice line which says that even the names of non-vegetarian food like murg masalam, they give such a flavor. They have such a flavor. And what about Nalin? He works as an engineer in a textile mill and he is all for his wife. Even after he loses his job, he says, "Now I'm sitting at home, I might as well type out all your recipes and, you know, make a cookbook for you." I really like the way he expresses himself. He says, "Yes, I am going to feel bad that you are going to be the breadwinner of the family, but I'll feel worse if you do not do this and give way to your special talent." Sharib Hashmi is wonderful at bringing out both Nalin's innate decency and his increasing, how do I put it, passive aggressiveness, because the man grows increasingly kind of inward and kind of regressive as his wife's success keeps increasing and increasing and increasing, and reminds him that he does not have a job anymore. Now, Tarla is naturally self-obsessed because she's never been in front of a TV. She doesn't know how to do cookbooks. Everything is new for her. So she's naturally a little self-obsessed. And she's also a little clueless to what's happening in the family. And all it would take for Nalin is to say, listen, calm down. I know you're doing all this, but sometimes think about me also, or sometimes think about the children also. But he does not have that conversation, because if he had that conversation, then he would have actually kind of communicated something to Tarla and made her calm down. Instead, now by making her hyper, keeping her hyper and keeping her the breadwinner of the family, he gets to feel increasingly more of a martyr. He gets to seethe silently and kind of make her feel guilty. Tarla moves through these touches deftly and with a lightness of touch that's refreshing. The film is bathed with bright colors. There's barely a shadow in sight. The music is cutesy and the scenes are cute too, like how Nalin gives marks out of 10 for everything, or how Tarla makes the family eat the same dish for a very, very long time till she gets the dish right. Huma gives a very broad performance. At times it feels like she's unable to locate the pitch, the meter of what she really wants to do. But then again, this is a very broad film. And I bought the broad ending where the Indian man is exposed for who he really is. Would I have liked more nuance in Tarla? Of course, because this seems to have been a fairly complicated life for a woman in a fairly complicated time. But then there is a smoothness to the film that makes it down go easy, like mom's home-cooked food. And that's it about Tarla. If you like this video review, do subscribe to Kalata Plus and see you soon at the movies.
Pallavaram Focus Menswear. Ippodhu Medavagathilum opening offer T-shirt verum 19, shirts 79 matchum anaitthu aadigalum 799-kul kidaikkum.